Well, hello, my Capricorns. Good afternoon. How are you cutie pies doing? Before I get into your reading, I just want to say that if you wondered about what's going on the weekends, I've been doing bonus readings. It's the top viewed signs. I'm doing, I take the top three most viewed signs and then I do the bonus reading. So it's basically what I do today plus four more cards. And that just goes more in detail of what the outcome is, if you're dealing with that other person, if there's another energy, what's their motivation, what are they thinking, what's in your feelings, you know, it just goes in more detail. So it really feels like a personal reading. So if you wonder what that's about, I'm pulling oracle cards to get the general energy for each sign. I'm saving you guys the trouble, especially, and you should be glad, Capricorn, it took the longest to get your cards. It took a good 10 minutes because I let the gods of the universe pick your cards. They have to come flying out. I don't want to make you guys sit through that. But it's interesting. I got flexible, which do you know, that's the Two of Pentacles, which is your card. And Two of Pentacles is about don't be too rigid. Don't expect things to look a certain way. Don't, like the Knight of Swords can think they can see something really clearly and they go after it, but maybe they don't have all the information. That's just, it's interesting, because then I have the Fool, which is also someone who just acts without really giving a whole lot of thought. This could be you, or this could be somebody around you. It could even be advice for somebody, one person out there, this beginning part before the read, because the co-create is working with others, but it's also like the Magician card. So I want to go back to this being flexible. When you're manifesting a relationship, or for instance, how about this with money? When people say, oh, I want to win the lottery, and then next week you get a scratch off ticket and you scratch and you win a dollar, and you don't realize you actually manifested that. Well, you did win the lottery, but you have to be specific, and you don't have to always, you have to be so specific and manifest consciously rather than subconsciously. Be within yourself when you do it. You're going to get better results, and be really clear with the universe, and with God or with spirit or whatever you deem your higher power. But yeah, flexibility is just also, sometimes it's okay to not be so rigid, because if there's a certain kind of relationship you want, it may not come in the form that you're used to. So be open to new things. I think short point, but a long way to get there. I should have just said that. Be open to new things, because something must be new coming in. And it might be a warning that co-create is working with others, but it may not come in the form, Capricorn, that you're used to seeing. So be flexible, okay? That's what that's saying about. All right. General energy for my Cappies. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. If you are Capricorn, know a Capricorn, feel like being a Capricorn. Well, Cappies, I'm so glad you guys are here. As always, adding some practicality to the tarot. All right, general energy for the Capricorns. All right, and happy birthday. You guys, it's gonna be, what is the date? No, that'll be next week. Okay, Capricorn season's next week. All right, well, happy early birthday. General energy for my Cappies, Magician reverse. Isn't that funny? This card comes out. Magician reverse, and then that oracle card is the Magician card, which is Virgo and Gemini. Virgo and Gemini. How crazy is that? Because Knight of Swords is Gemini. Sorry. Got excited there. And there's you. All right. What's influencing the Magician reverse? What's influencing the Magician reverse? What is it? And the Queen of Pentacles. It's you upright. You just want to do your thing. And see, she's focused on that pentacle. Capricorn, I have no doubt you're probably focused on your money and your stability, taking care of all the people around you, but getting shit done. Queen of Pentacles can run a business. She can run a home. She can tend to a garden. She can paint the wall. The Queen of Pentacles can do it all. And she knows. She's able to do it. This Magician reverse may not be you. It may not be you. It may be somebody that's really hard to work with, or somebody manipulating you and undermining you or underestimating you. When you have the ability to do it all, but somebody is kind of trying their best to almost, it feels like sabotaging energy, actually. What is the reason for the reading? What's the reason for the reading? What is the reason for the reading? Why are we all here today, Capricorns? What is it? And the World. Ooh, another major arcana. Look at that. closing something out, no unfinished business. Capricorn might be like, okay, I'm taking this Knight of Swords. I see you clearly. Go. You need to go. All right. It's funny, the magician has the infinity symbol about above his head. And the first thing I thought was, with it reversed, it's this situation is now finite. It's coming to an end because you're getting on my nerves. What's in the past? What's in the past for Capricorn? Yeah, magician reverse is a very sneaky, underhanded energy. What's in the past? And the sun, happiness. I think that you, Queen of Pentacles, you were just doing your thing, making your money, hope, happiness, living in the moment. Leo energy. What is on 3 out of 4 major arcana? That's pretty impressive. What's on your mind, Capricorn? What is on Cappy's mind? What is on Cappy's mind? The Queen of Cups reverse. Why do I feel like this is attached to a magician reverse? We have two queens, one reverse. Even if you're a male-female, male-male, female-female, yeah, it could be, it doesn't matter. There's no gender applied. It's energy, and everybody has masculine and feminine energies. But a Queen of Cups reverse is somebody that could be very emotionally unavailable, somebody that could have even, that deals with neediness, that deals with depression issues, anxiety issues, definitely anxiety issues. But what I got really is emotional unavailability. And with this magician reverse, it just feels very sneaky. It feels very sneaky. What is in the near future? What is in the near future for Capricorn? What is in the near future? I feel like you're letting them go, whoever this is. What's in the near future? And the Page of Pentacles. Oh, I'm sorry. It could be definitely a new beginning. And also, for some of you, it could be money's coming your way. I know for many Christians, you know, Christmas is coming, and maybe Santa's got a brand new bag. But Page of Pentacles, it definitely could be just a message and a message. You might have actually some unexpected money coming in. But the Page of Pentacles is an offer or an apology. Mm-hmm. Maybe because you got tired of this. Six of Cups is a comeback around, trying to make this right. Page of Swords reverse and a Knight of Swords reverse. Okay, Capricorn, let's see what's going on. Let's see what's going on here. What's the Magician reverse and the Queen of Pentacles upright? I just feel like somebody's messing with your energy and you're not liking it. What is the Magician reverse and the Queen of Pentacles upright for Capricorn? Magician reverse and the Queen. This may not necessarily be love. It could be work. It definitely can be like maybe a new employee at the job with the world. And you are just like, I don't know if I can work with this person. They're all about themselves. They're reckless. They don't think. They throw people under the bus. And Page of Pentacles could be very immature energy too. Or trying to make it right. Could be an apology. But what is the Magician reverse and the Queen of Pentacles upright? The Magician reverse and the Queen of Pentacles upright. It is the Six of Swords. Moving on. Moving away from a Magician reverse. I'm definitely feeling that. Six of Swords is moving to calmer waters. Maybe you're moving to a different job, or moving from a job, or from a relationship, or from an energy, from home. I mean, it really could be so many different things. Sometimes I get one storyline so clearly, but this one I'm feeling it for maybe different people. It just feels like it's just a lot of different scenarios here. What is the Six of Swords and the Queen of Pentacles? Why is the Six of Swords here? And the Ten of Swords, or Ten of Wands, burden. This feels like, if this is within work, this person comes in. Here's a scenario. This person comes in, Capricorn, and makes you feel like you don't know how to do your job. I think they might be younger than you. This is also like a student. Could even be like, let's say, an intern. You know, somebody that comes in, they haven't been doing it as well as you or as long as you, but somehow they will tell you what to do. Because they can't do it themselves, the Magician reverse. And I feel like there's like throwing people under the bus energy going on. And the Ten of Wands and the Six of Swords, I feel like you're just moving away from the burden of this. It's becoming burdensome. And it's starting to mess with your energy and your effectiveness. And maybe you're losing your Two of Pentacles. You're about starting to lose your shit with this energy. Because it's just, they question everything you do, but they don't add to it. This is a person who has, that will tell you all your ideas are wrong, but they have no solutions. You know how, have you ever met those people in life or within work? And if this is like a meddling mother-in-law, somebody who always tells you how to do things, but yet they can't even praise you when you do something right. And it could be, I don't know, it could be around kids, but what is the world, the reason for the reading? I think you're just getting away from this energy. What is the world for Capricorns? What is that, the world doing here? It is the Four of Wands reverse. Yeah, I think you're leaving this behind or you're kicking them out. It's, I mean, if especially if you're married to this or you're living with them or there was that hope, I think it's like your head's not in the clouds about this anymore. And maybe it never was. But this Queen of Cups reverse is in the Magician reverse is very manipulative. It's underhandedness. And this is very, it feels very gaslighting to me where they make you feel like you're the problem. You're the one creating the disturbances. It's all in your head. I'm not cheating on you. You could literally have video evidence and this person won't admit to it. Give me, yeah, Four of Wands reverse in the world. It's definitely closing out instability. It's closing, I mean, it's, you thought with the sun that you found the one, if this was a relationship, but yet your foundation is built on quicksand. You're sinking, you're drowning here. Okay, what is this? The world and the Four of Wands reverse. What is that? Aries energy, Four of Wands. What is that? And the Two of Cups. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. Yeah, Four of Wands reverse. Sorry, I'm talking to myself. Why the Two of Cups? Capricorn, do you have someone on the side? Actually, I think they might have someone on the side. You could too, but maybe that's what you caught. Yep, Knight of Cups reverse is your inappropriate lover card. Coming in the back way. I think you could have been dealing with somebody that had somebody on the side. And maybe that's what you found out. Yeah, this reading is something else. Just feels so manipulative and so it's the energy is very immature here. And now that you caught them and now that you're moving on from them or cutting them out, and here comes the small apology. But you know what, this it's small. It's this probably comes after like a King of Swords reverse or after a Magician reverse, after they blow up and then it's like, oh yeah, I'm sorry about that. If they even say sorry, it just feels like a lot of instability going on. What is the sun in the past for Capricorns? What's the sun in the past, Leo energy? What is that card? Sun in the past. What is the sun in the past? It is the Eight of Swords reverse. You know what's weird is the past feels like the present. And maybe you feel like you've done this before. Maybe it has been a repeating cycle with this person. So it does feel repeating. I think that's what why that feels like the future, because this person, this feels like a circle, and it kind of is a circle, but here comes this person to offer a small apology, and then we're thrown back here again to make it better. And to, it's like in between the Ten of Wands, like you dropping it, you catching them, you tired of this, I'm moving on, Six of Swords, then you feel better. Eight of Swords reverse, right? You're starting to get that happiness back. You're starting to get your flexibility back. You're getting your Pentacles. Two of Pentacles is upright. Your energy is back. And then here comes this person again. It feels very repetitive. Feels very repetitive. What is the Queen of Cups reverse on your mind? If this is a family thing, it's kind of like you forgive them just for them to do the same thing to you. What is the Queen of Cups reverse on Capricorn's mind? What's the Queen of Cups reverse on Capricorn's mind? Cancer energy. Oh, who is she? Who is she? We got a Queen of Cups reverse. I'm still getting used to these images. Queen of Cups reverse is clarifying a Queen of Cups reverse. That's tarot saying, and I mean it. She's really reversed. She's really unavailable. She really only takes, but she doesn't fill my cup. She's only there for the good times and leaves. And she's probably even, if this is a lover, has somebody on the side. Two of Cups and a Knight of Cups reverse. And I feel, Capricorn, why we're having this reading is, if that's true, you I can't wait to clarify this Page of Pentacles, because I don't think you're going back around. I don't think so. I think before this came in, the reason for the reading, if you didn't know about this, you possibly would forgive this person and take them back. Because I just feel like with this flexibility, I feel like it's more about what they put on you, because I feel like there's a lot of gaslighting going on here. So they put on you like you're the problem. You're the one who's causing the issues. Why can't we work together? How can we work together when you're the one always accusing me of being in the wrong? But I'm telling you, I think a Capricorn is going to get some good evidence that there is somebody else, or there is something else going on, especially around the love. Because unless you have love in the workplace, that Knight of Cups reverse on the Two of Cups, yeah, that doesn't feel good. That doesn't feel good. What is the Page of Pentacles in the near future? What is the Page of Pentacles in the near future? You know, and Pentacles is your card, Cap. Maybe that's what they're worried about. That's why they come back in. Yeah, Ace of Cups. No, Ace of Pentacles. The offer you. It's kind of like a close-up. It's like a, here's the Page of Pentacles, the offer. And then, I don't know, this sounds silly. It's like a close-up look on that. No, Ace of Pentacles is a new beginning or a new comeback around. But I actually think, give me another card on that. Give me another card. We have all this Magician reverse, two Queen of Cups reverse around it. And when I say a close-up, I think that's what this person thinks. Yeah, and now the Knight of Pentacles, the progression going on. Knight of Pentacles, Virgo energy. I think they're going to come in and say, let's work together, we can do this. But is it because they want you, or are they afraid that somebody else is going to get you? Because it feels like they may have something else going on. There's something shady. There's something really shady going on here with the world, the Two of Cups, and the Knight of Cups reverse. After a Four of Wands reverse. I feel like the Four of Wands reverse and the world happens, because you find out that it has to be over. You close that door. Because I just feel like they have something else going on. I really do. What is this? Page of Pentacles, Ace of Pentacles, and the Knight of Pentacles. Look at all that earth energy coming out. What is that? And the Three of Swords. Yeah, they try to make it better. But again, the question is do they want you, or do they not want anyone else to have you? What is it? Because it's a small offer. And the Knight of Pentacles is slow progression. And see, the Knight is actually going back towards the Queen of Pentacles. They don't want you getting away. That's the thing. They just don't want you getting away. They don't want anyone else to have you. But yet, I'm telling you, Capricorn, I'm feeling somebody else here. A third or a fourth energy going on. And I think whoever story this is, I think you probably do too, which is why you ended it and decided to close the door. And not just close the door. It's like Monsters Incorporated. You know where they shred the door and you keep, so there's no door that exists anymore. That's how done you are. But now they come in with a small offer. And then it gets a little, the Ace of Pentacles is like a new beginning. Let's start over. Let's forgive the past. Knight of Pentacles is kind of, it's a very slow energy. And it's usually, it's a very patient energy. But I don't, with that Magician be in reverse, I think everything you see here is kind of, you have to look deeper. You have to look deeper than what it is. Because just like, remember at the beginning, at the bottom of the deck, the Knight of Swords, even if you think you know, you may not even really know. Because I feel like they make these promises, like a Knight of Cups reverse can make promises they can't back up. It's just to try to heal things, to get back here so we can get this beginning, but nothing changes. It's just so repetitive. And I'm starting to repeat myself here. What is the bottom of the deck? Yeah, again, we have a Magician and a Knight of Pentacles. It was actually a Magician reverse and a Knight of Pentacles. Wow. Actually, this is the Page of Pentacles. This is the Page of Pentacles. Sorry, guys. I told you I'm getting, this is in Italian, so please forgive me. But yeah, this is the Page of Pentacles. Again, it's something small. And you think, in the past, I think you took them up on it, but it really didn't change. The Knight of Pentacles, You know, the Knight of Pentacles is the only horse in tarot that doesn't move. And I feel like this relationship really doesn't even move forward. But the Magician reverse, we have two Magician reverses. Maybe some of you are dealing with a Virgo or another earth energy. But the Page of Pentacles is a small offer, a small apology. It doesn't even feel like they truly even mean it. Just to get you back here. Just to get you like 3 days, 5 days where everything's going good so they can get you back under there. But then it repeats itself. So why would you do that? And again, I feel like this is a Capricorn. And I'm sorry, this might only be one person's reading out there. It really feels like they want you back just so nobody else can have you. It's so selfish. And that really what a Magician reverse and a Queen of Cups reverse is. They have somebody, but they don't want you to have anybody. So they want to keep you there because you're so loyal and you would be there for them. I don't know, Cappies. I'm sorry. This was something else. I was hoping it would have, I thought it would go somewhere, anywhere but here. This is kind of icky, I'll be honest. All right, my Capricorns, I hope you guys have a good rest of your week, and I will see you later. Take care.